Tonight, parents are together with their kids for dinner. They're eating old favorite dishes with new favorites on the side and sharing stories of their doings for the day. But tonight, we aren't at a dinner table or a costly restaurant. We're at the Church of West Kensington, where Linda Samost and Reverend Adon have opened their weekly services for all to attend, known as the Church of West Kensington's Sunday Supper Program.
What we're trying to do is transform the way people relate to food. So we're trying to help them change their behaviors in terms of how they purchase food, how they prepare it, and then how they share it.
Reverend Adon has empowered Linda Samost to assemble volunteers from across the neighborhood that cook meals for all and every family member that attends. And as they do, Linda teaches them the importance of eating dinner as a family.
There has been a lot of research that shows that when you have a family meal, the positives in terms of reduced drug and alcohol use, in terms of improved academics, in terms of better nutrition, better communication, there are far-reaching kind of impacts of having a family meal. We teach them how to cook it, so we actually have skill-building classes. And then, when they leave after every supper, they get a bag of groceries and a recipe.
But these foods aren't just any other cuisine. They have standards to fill before they can be served.
We don't fry anything, and we don't use processed food. So it's all fresh, and we use as few ingredients to make it as simple as possible.
Though there is no admittance fee of any kind, the church has asked that those who attend adhere to two easy rules.
One is that you have to turn off your phone, and you have to turn off any electronics that you have. So that's number one. But the second one is that you have to try everything. Certainly, we're not going to give them all food that they don't know or whatever, but we do introduce new things.
The effects of this program are very apparent. People not only cooperate with the rules, but they become immersed in the experience of having supper with a more productive quality to it.
It's really helpful, the program. Pretty much, I enjoy it. I have a great time. I spend time with my kids because I work, and I try to, you know, find in places that entertain with our families and everything. And I've been to other places, but it's not the way how it is here. Everybody just smiling. Everybody gets along. We laugh. Like, it's just so different that you can feel the energy. You feel everything is so different.
Some even feel inspired to get involved.
My name is Mike Torres. I'm with an organization called MIMIC, Men in Motion the Community, and I volunteer here at Sunday Suppers. For me, I'm actually giving back to the community from what I took from it for many years. I was a drug dealer, and I had a corner down the street from here on Howard and Dolphin, and I sold drugs for many years to the people in this community. It's got to be a way to give back for all the damage that I did for so many years. So I ended up joining an organization called MIMIC, Men in Motion the Community. And as I came to volunteer, I ended up staying. I've been here ever since the beginning of Sunday Suppers. And for me, that's just my way of giving back for so many years of damage that I think I did to this community.
With this program, Reverend Adon hopes he'll be able to reinvent how people look at their faith. Though the practice of spending supper with family is beneficial, it's a dying practice. But with Linda's help, Adon hopes he will not only revitalize this long-time tradition, but also help bring Christianity back to the dinner table.
People are definitely changing the way that they're relating to food and moving away from, they're making better choices. This isn't about, it's not a black and white issue. It's about giving people information so that they can make the choices that they choose to make.